Well, hello, friends. Welcome to our online Sunday school for preschoolers at North Park Community Church. I'm really glad that you are here with us today. And maybe you are sitting with a brother or a sister or mom or dad. And so a welcome to everybody who is watching. We are going to have so much fun today as we learn again about God's amazing love. And we're going to start off by playing a little game. Does that sound like a good idea? It does to me. I love to play games. And this game is all about having three choices. Okay? So, can you count to three with me? Ready? One. Two. Three. Good job! Counting all the way up to three. So in this game, I'm going to ask you a question, and then I'm going to show you a picture of three things. And I want you to choose which picture is the correct answer. Okay? So are you ready? Which of the following animals makes this awesome sound? Moo. Can you guess? Is it a dog? Is it a cow? Or is it a bunny? Which is it, friends? Did you say a cow? That's right. A cow says moo. Do you want to try making a moo sound with me? Ready? On the count of three. One, two, three. Moo. Good job. I thought you did great. Here's question number two. When you are taking a bath, and you want to wash your hair, which bottle would you choose? Would you choose the bottle of jam? The bottle of ketchup? Or the bottle of shampoo? That's right! You would use your shampoo, wouldn't you? It would be kind of silly to wash your hair with ketchup, or it would be really sticky to wash your hair with jam. Shampoo is what's going to get your hair nice and clean. Good job. Are you ready now for question number three? Question number three is, if you wanted to go to the lake this summer and catch a fish, which of these tools would you use? Would you use a hammer? Would you use a flip-flop? Or would you use a fishing pole? Which would you use? That's right! You would use a fishing pole so that you could maybe catch a fish. Now, wouldn't that be exciting? Well, friends, you did an amazing job playing my game of three choices. And you know what that reminds me of? The number three? It reminds me of the three really important things that our Bibles teach us about God. That's right. If you have your Bible, this is mine. And if you have your Bible always teaches you three things. You know what they are. They teach you, one, that God made you. That's right. God made you. The second thing the Bible teaches is that God loves you, right? Give yourself a big hug because God loves you so, so much. And the third thing the Bible teaches us is that Jesus wants to be our friend forever. Aren't these three amazing truths that we learn from the Bible? And they're things that we can believe and we can know because the Bible is God's word. The Bible is God's word. And today we have a really amazing Bible story about how we can trust in God no matter what. But before we go to the clubhouse and we hang out with our friends Lucy and Louise and Ollie, we're going to sing a song together. It's a song called No Matter What, and it's all about how God loves us and Jesus is our very, very best friend. So why don't we get ready to sing? Then we'll go to the clubhouse for the story, and I'll see you in just a few minutes.
It's a beautiful day, I wanna celebrate. I wanna tell everyone, I just can't wait. He is my friend, he is so great. He can do anything, I just can't wait.
Hi there, I'm Lucy, and my grandma gave us this music player for the clubhouse. Melody?
Good morning.
Can you please play us some marching music?
Playing marching music?
How cool is that? I love marching music, so I bought these rhythm sticks to keep time. Can you use your hands and clap along with me? Hands up. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, that's great. Now let's go slow. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now let's go super fast. 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4. Woof, you guys did great. You can put your hands down now. Marching music is so much fun. Sometimes I imagine what it would be like to lead a real marching band. Wow, how amazing would that be?
Who? Who?
It's Ollie.
Hello, Lucy. Who? Who? Marching around in time, are you?
I sure am, Ollie. I love marching music so much.
Marching is lots of fun. Hoo, hoo. So I've got a marching story for you. Listen to this. Just follow me through. Hoo, hoo.
Follow me through. Follow me through. Ollie's got a Bible story for me and you.
Oh, hola, friends. I'm Luis the Handyman. And look what I've got today. It's a ram's horn. It's like a trumpet for our story. And boy, is it a story. Do you want to help me build it? Ha-ha! Great! Let's put it on the story fence. Hammers up, little builders. Ready? Uno, dos, tres, hammer! Great job, little helpers. You can put your hammers down. Now, we just need our story tools. Yep, we have everything we need. Today's true story from the Bible begins with a guy named Joshua. Now, Joshua was the leader of God's army. One day, God told Joshua that he was going to take the city of Jericho. Except, look! The city of Jericho had a huge wall that went all the way around it. It was big, it was strong, and the city was very hard to get into. I don't understand. How can Joshua and his army take the city if there's a huge wall around it? But Joshua trusted that God's plan would work. God told Joshua to take horns like this and march around the big wall blowing trumpets one time a day for 6 days. What? Blow trumpets and march? Joshua didn't understand how God's plan would work, but Joshua trusted God anyway. So, Joshua gathered his army and got ready to march around the big wall. Everyone, stand up. Now, get ready to march in place and blow your pretend trumpets. Ready? Go! March, 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 march. They march on day one. They march on day two. Day three. Day four. Day five. Day six. And then stop. That was awesome marching. You can sit down now. Great job. On day seven, God said, I want you to march around the wall 7 times. Then when Joshua says go, give a loud shout. Okay, but not until Joshua says go. So Joshua still didn't understand. How would shouting and trumpets break down a wall? But Joshua trusted God. So they started marching around the city. Ooh, can you count with me? They marched around the city. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then Joshua said, go! Everybody shout! And the wall came down. They won! Great job, everyone! Woohoo! Wow! God is amazing! Sometimes we may not understand how God's plan will work, but we can trust God. Hey there, Ollie. Tell me, who can trust God?
I can trust God. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me, who can trust God?
I can trust God. That's the truth, friends. You better believe it. Adios!
So there's your story, and it's all true. Joshua trusted God's plan, so he went for a long march. Hoo! Hoo!
Thanks, Ollie!
Goodbye to you. Hoo! Hoo!
Wow! Joshua trusted God's plan and marched around the walls, and they fell down. I can trust God's plan too. I think I got the story. Did you get it? If you did, say got it. Get it?
Got it!
Good! Maybe God has a plan for me to lead a marching band sometime. I better keep practicing. Melody, play another march, please.
Playing marching music.
1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2.
Well, hello again, friends. Wasn't that an amazing story from the Bible today about how Joshua learned he could trust in God as he and the Israelites marched around the walls of Jericho? How many times? That's right, 7 times. Not 3, 1, 2, 3, but 7 times. And I'm here with 7 stuffies. Would you help me count to 7 along with these stuffies? Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. That's right, friends. Joshua learned that he could trust God no matter what, even when he didn't understand how marching around the walls would help them fall down. He chose to trust in God. And you know, that reminds me of our Bible verse for this month. Would you say it together with me if you can? Here it is up on the screen. I trust in God. I am not afraid. Psalm 56, verse 11. I trust in God. I am not afraid. This is what Joshua could say because he trusted God. And this is what you and I can say when we choose to trust in God as well. Because no matter what, we can always trust God. Because God made us, God loves us, and Jesus wants to be our friend forever. Isn't that wonderful news? I hope that you know this week and always that you can trust in God. Let's close our time together today in prayer, just talking to God. So let's take one hand and bring it up and bring our other hand right beside it. And then we'll bring them together. We'll fold our hands and we'll close our eyes and let's talk to God. Dear God, thank you so much that you made us and that you love us and that Jesus wants to be our friend forever. And thank you that we can trust in you no matter what. We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, thank you so much for joining me today, friends and family. I'm so glad that you did. And we hope to see you again next week for our online services here at North Park. Until then, take care, be safe, and trust in God. Bye-bye.